I started speaking and traveling full time, I spent 9 years counseling in crisis pregnancy centers in Chicago and in Minneapolis, St. Paul. And for 9 years, I would have girls in my office every day saying, Pam, I didn't know. And after 9 years, I realized that there were a lot of students out there making decisions about sex, having absolutely no idea what the consequence of that choice would be. My goal is that none of you would be able to leave here and ever again have to say to a physician, to a counselor, to your future husband or wife, nobody told me. I didn't know. Students, God created sex. It's awesome. God wants you to have great sex. He does. This is not about wrecking your fun. Now listen, God created sex. It was His idea, not yours. But God created sex with boundaries. And when sex happens within boundaries, it's awesome. When it happens outside of boundaries, it's horribly, horribly destructive. Help me out. What is the boundary or the context for which God created sex? Mary, there's the right answer. Most of you don't believe that. Here is the rule. Here is the simple law of God. If you are not married, don't do it. If you have sex outside of the sacrament of marriage, if you have sex outside of one monogamous, and monogamy does not mean one at a time, one partner who has only been with you. If you have sex outside of that context, you'll pay. There's a cost. No one has ever broken the law of God. No one has ever shaken their fist in His face and told them they could do it their way and didn't need His law and not paid. The question has got to be, what is the cost? And is it worth paying? Today, November 4th, today, in the next 24 hours, 12,000 teens will contract a sexually transmitted disease. Today. 12,000 more tomorrow. Since in the 1950s, we had 5 sexually transmitted diseases we knew about were treating. 5! You could count them on one hand! Today we've got over 30 sexually transmitted diseases, 30% of them absolutely incurable. That means you get one of these diseases and you've got it for life. The HPV, genital warts, syphilis, gonorrhea, herpes, chlamydia, trichinomas, vulvodynia, arthritis, hepatitis B, hepatitis C, HIV, list goes on and on and on. These are serious diseases, students, with serious consequences. The number one sexually transmitted disease in this country and around the world is human papilloma virus, HPV. This is a virus. What does that mean? You get it. You got it for life. No cure. You will give it to everyone you have sex with after infection. This is not only the most common virus, this is the most contagious. HPV is the number one cause of lesion of cervical cancer in women.
Sunt Sanda Nicola, am 31 de ani și am supraviețuit unui cancer de col uterin. Aveam 27 de ani, credeam că lumea e a mea, sau dacă încă nu e a mea, cu siguranță sunt pe cale să o cuceresc. Toate mergeau din plin, eram pe val. Și a venit acest moment în care, brusc, mi-am amintit că, de fapt, sunt foarte mică. Sunt neînsemnată. Înainte de intervenția în sine, bineînțeles că au fost biopsiile. Bineînțeles că au fost testele pentru HPV. Sunt momente îngrozitoare.
And in tears she said this. Well, why didn't you come to my school 3 months ago? Nobody told me this. Didn't know. Hung up the phone, sat alone that night and thought, would she have heard me? Think she would have listened? Or would she have sat like hundreds of teens and still found a way to say, it's not gonna happen to me?
Am avut o bună perioadă, niște atitudini foarte dârze, foarte demne, foarte... E o bagatelă, e ceva mic, nu, e imposibil. Mie n-are cum să mi se întâmple asta.
I don't think this is complicated. I don't think this is tough. I think you can understand this. Here it is. Absolutely no genital contact of any kind. None. He's in saying no to sex won't hurt you. Once you've said yes, you've lost all guarantees. And young man, the integrity you show yourself, the discipline and control you show yourself and every girl you date is very indicative of what we can expect from you long term. Girls, the respect and integrity you show yourself and every guy you date is pretty indicative of what we can expect from you long term. Girls, you want respect? You have to demand it. Students, hear what God says love is. Love is patient, It's kind. It's not rude. It's not selfish. It would never damage someone and hurt them. It's not love, it's selfishness. I know that my God is so awesome and so amazing that he is capable of taking your worst pain, whether it was something that you chose or whether it was something that was done to you. And my God can make something very beautiful come from that. It's called amazing grace. Let me tell you something else about this God. He knows that there will always be people who will do it their way. And that's why he provided his son as a sacrifice for us when we blow it. One of the options is you ask for forgiveness, you walk out of here and you start over. The other option is you harden your fists in the face of God and tell him one more time you don't need his rules and you can do it your way. And you walk out of here the same as you were when you walked in. And let me give you a little promise. I know where is at the end of that road. It's death. Death is at the end of that road. The Bible says the wages of sin is death. The gift of God is eternal life. The choice is to walk in the life of Christ or to choose death.